I'm Chandler Mason, and this is my last lecture. I was born November 25th, 2002, in a city called Columbus, Georgia.
Although I didn't know why I was here, California was very different from Georgia. The way people talked and the accents they had was very different. They had a proper grammar, as to say, and we had a weird type of language. I was bullied because of the accent I had, and the accent I had I really did love, but I had to change so I could prevail through all of it. And to prevail, I had to never give up, on who I truly am. Even though I moved from city to city, I never gave up to who I truly am, and all that hope that I gave to other people and the hope they gave to me.
This hope made people come into my life that changed it dramatically, like Auntie Carolyn. Auntie Carolyn was adopted by a family, but never really knew her real mother, and all her family was adopted. She never stopped giving to the people that needed her the most. She never stopped to think about how her actions would have changed people's lives, but she changed mine. She taught me never giving up on people or things we do can change our lives dramatically.
This wasn't the only event that changed my life. The other one is when I got bullied. I was taunted every single day because of the way I spoke. And the way I spoke was way different from when they did. They thought I was different, so they decided that bullying people would be the best way to overcome
it. I remember it constantly, like it was yesterday. It was just something I had to get through. But when I decided that I wasn't gonna let it change me, it was the most amazing moment of my life. I decided that insecurities weren't anything to deal with. It was just something people wanted to do because they're insecure about themselves. This is just one of the teachings never giving up can give you. Although everything is great, bullying is something bad for people in society, and basketball and sports are still things people love. But why do people give up? Because they have nothing else to do? Or is it because everyone around them decides that they're a failure at life? Why do people give up? Because they're too afraid of things to change. Things can change, but they won't let it. Things change when people let them change, not the other way around. Things don't change dramatically with the snap of a finger, like your Thanos.
Things change in baby steps, small steps that lead to a better life for everyone else around them.
These baby steps can have so much effect on people's lives. These baby steps can make people better at basketball, better at anything, even music. That reminds me of a story, how never giving up on my life on basketball had changed it forever. I was in sixth grade and I tried out for the basketball team. I got cut that year. That year, I decided that I'll get on the basketball team next year. So I tried my hardest and never gave up on what I wanted to do. I wanted to be the very best in the team, but eighth grade year, I became captain. That year, I never forgot that never giving up got me to this place. It got me to this beautiful place I call a court. It got me all the respect that I needed. It gave me hope. This hope gave me the confidence I needed to go into my freshman year strong, but yet still far from my dream, never knowing if I'm going to get to my dream. So I remember Auntie Carolyn's teaching, and I remember that never giving up can give me so many things. It got me to the place I was in eighth grade, so why can't it get me here? Like the movies, the story really never ends. My freshman year wasn't that great. I had to stay on the bench for most of the time, and I was mostly benched my entire season. It was difficult for me knowing that I could be great, but yet I was stuck on a bench, stuck in this place that I really didn't like. So I tried training, and I never gave up on doing basketball until I got an offer that I could never refuse, playing on a team that I could never refuse to play on. And I decided that I'd work harder, 10 times harder than I was working. So I never gave up on my dream. Even though my coach put me on the bench, he couldn't put my spirits on the bench. It was never there. Someone said you can put a champion on the bench, but you can never put the bench on the champion's heart. The champion's heart can go a long way. Like never giving up can go a long way. The champion's mentality is like the mama mentality, never giving up, even if all hope is lost. This reminds me of what my dad says all the time. The game is hard, Chandler, and you have to know that. So if you want to play the game, you should never give up. Even if the world tells you you should give up, never give up. even if the world tells you it's not good enough, even if your coach tells you you're not good enough, never give up.
So with that being said, I go hard in practice. And even if my body tells me I'm tired and just trying to give up, even if my mind is telling me I suck, even if the players around me tell me I'm suck, even if the coach tells me I should give up, even if the world tells me I'm wrong, I'll never give up on my dream, and I'll never give up on the people around me. Just like Auntie Carolyn never gave up on me, I'll never give up on anyone else. This is what never giving up has taught me. Even if the world around you is crumbling, and all the people around you start hating you, never give up. Never give up on life. Never give up on anything you love. Never give up, even if the world tells you you can't do it. Because that's what the greatest people ever told me, that they couldn't do it, and they did it. So why can't we?
It's our choice, whether to never give up and be successful, or to give up and be average. It's our choice. So what do you choose? To be an average athlete, or to be a spectacular athlete who works hard for what he has? Even if athletic ability is not what you were born with, you can develop it.